Okay, so good morning, everyone. Yesterday there was educational round 93, and I was not able to upload the solution of C because I did not get it within the contest duration time. But I kept trying, and today morning actually I woke up and I solved the problem. And it's a quite simple solution. I hope you all know how to find number of subarrays whose sum is exactly k. There is a problem in Geeks for Geeks. You will find it everywhere actually. But please go and see count of subarrays having sum k. So you will get an idea as to how to approach the problem, because this is also the same thing, right? This problem, we have to find the number of good subarrays. We have to count the subarrays whose sum is equal to length of the subarray. So this is something similar, not exactly that. So I first request you to go and see the problem. Maximum number of subarrays whose sum is exactly k. That's the problem title. So in this problem, we have to find the number of subarrays whose length is equal to the subarray length. So how to approach the problem? First of all, take the input, then keep a map. Basically, this question revolves around mapping and prefix sums. So keep a map, and what are we going to map? We are going to map the number of times, that is how many times we get answer zero. We want the answer zero, right? We want the sum equal to length of the subarray. So sum minus length of subarray, we want it to be zero. Then only we can say sum is equal to length of subarray. I hope you're understanding. We can only say that sum minus length of subarray is equal to zero when sum is equal to length of subarray. So this map will store all the occurrences of such instances wherein sum minus length of subarray becomes zero. So keep a map, initialize m of 0 to 1, because subarray of length 0 will always have a sum 0. Subarray of length 0 will have a sum always 0 only. So this sum is calculating the prefix sum, and s of I minus 48 is done to convert it into integer because it is a string. So I am adding, and this is calculating the prefix sum, and I am checking this sum minus I plus 1. Basically over here, I plus 1 is the length and sum is the sum value. So I am checking how many occurrences of this value is there in the map, and I'm counting all of that. Basically, this will lead to giving the answer for the problem. And most important thing is this one, this condition. I was messing up here. If you know how to find the maximum number of subarrays whose sum is exactly k, then this condition is different. In that problem, we do this. We do sum of m of sum plus plus. Sorry, m of sum plus plus. That means in the map, we increment the current sum. We do not increment this value in that question. So this was the mistake I was doing. And now I have corrected that. This was the same mistake I was doing from yesterday. It was a very simple problem. I wish I'd have got it yesterday itself, but it's okay. I learned something new. I hope you also learned something new. This is the way to solve the problem. It's a very simple problem. I also request you to see the other problem, maximum number of subarrays whose sum is exactly k. That is also a very good problem. And you will understand this problem much better if you know that problem. So please understand that problem. This becomes very easy to understand otherwise. Okay, so the mistake I was doing was in this condition. I was not able to understand why I was doing a mistake, but now I have solved it, and I hope you can understand the solution. It's a very simple solution. You can read it only and understand actually now. So that's all for this video. If you have not seen my other videos, please subscribe to my channel and watch them. Share it with your friends. Also, I've uploaded A and B in yesterday's video. You can check out that, or I can put it in the description also. So that's all for this video. And thank you. Bye.